guys. I'm just making a video. This is the laser printer I got off of Leafster. I've decided to go with a smaller printer because it's massive. And decided to strip it down for parts. Some of the parts that I do save, obviously the power supply. I saved the capstan here. This thing has actually got a lot of power. Stepper motor, you save that. All the wiring. Save all the wiring. All this wiring is great for projects. Take a look at that. That's the, well, it's a laser printer, so that's the laser that puts the image on the drum. I'll fire it up, let you see what it looks like. Fire it up. There's a little door on the laser that I have that's closed, so that way won't hurt my eyes. So we'll just keep that closed, and we'll show you what it looks like.
What are you saying?
Spins pretty fast. We're going to take that all apart. Show you what this looks like, the capstan when it spins. This thing has got a lot of torque. You can use this, this is three phase, so you can use this on an e-bike controller if you want to make a little tester. But, that's got a lot of torque. So let's start taking this thing apart and see what we can dig out of it. Well, there's the three phase motor out. You can see the three phases there. This one actually has a plastic gear. Most of them have a steel gear. But all you have to do really is just desolder those three wires there and add your own wires off of that and disable the board. But we'll fire it up again. Plug it in here. Whoa, that's got some torque. Sensing there's no motor. I don't know if it'll keep spinning or not. Try it again. Nope. Okay, let's keep going. Start pulling all the ribbon cables. It's unplugged now, so don't save any of this stuff, because you'll never find a use for it. Especially made for this printer, so just keep pulling all the wires. I'm interested to see what the power supply looks like. Also the laser. I'm interested to see what that looks like too. Like all this here. It's all savable. Good for projects when you need fine wire. You save a buck here or there, then you can spend it on other things on the project, so. Lots of that wire. I don't know where that goes, but I want it. Wire here. Yankety yank. Whoa! What the hell that was? There's your display. Or it was. It's off. This is for the laser. That's the board there where the laser is covered. Oh, that was the cover. It's already off and now, so. Okay, let's take this board off here. There's the two boards off. That's a PMC. I'm guessing that's the RAM there, and then you get an extra RAM slot. That's your power supply there. There's some surface mount stuff on the back. Networking, USB, and this is the one that for the control. Main power jack there. Some surface mount stuff on the back. Okay, I want to take a look at the gears here. So I guess we'll just keep digging. I'll take that stepper motor off too. It's the stepper motor out. steel aluminum gear. Okay, let's take this plate off here and take a look at that laser. Okay, I got it out. This is actually kind of cool. I thought this had just one laser, but apparently if you look at the laser itself, it's got four in there. It splits this into four sections, and then it has four different shades of glass in there for different colors. The dark one on the end there for yellow. That's kind of cool. So that's the board for the laser there. I'm going to take that apart and take a look at it. Well, there was no way to get it out without damaging the board. But there you go, there's four laser diodes that could be used with lenses. That's cool. And it goes in there. I wonder if these are all glass. These mirrors here are glass. These ones here are plastic. So most of them are glass, except for these two. Break it and find out. If someone's into lasers, they would find some of these lenses useful. The glass ones anyway. This one feels like it's plastic. That's for the laser. Yeah, the laser coming out. Switch hands here. Those are plastic. And that spins. The laser hits that. Bounces up and down. Cool. That's about it. Not much more to it than that. I'll make a mess. Oh. Keep the wiring here. T for trash. Okay, what else? There's a board on the other side. We can take a look at it. This is the high voltage side. You can see all the rails there. And that makes contact with these springs here, which in turn makes contact with all the drums that were in there. Still digging. Can't really save that. The wire goes through there. Let's see what we get. Well, there's the power supply. It was actually a two-piece. The mains goes in here, goes through here, and out through there, and then in through here, and through this way. 120 volts. Let's see what the voltage is coming out. Maybe I can use this for a future project. Let's see, 3.3 volts, 24 volts, and that's about it. 3 volts and 24 volts only. Pretty solid. Well, I'll save it. Never know when you need it. So that's about it, guys. I mean, I found another stepper motor, but other than that, it's just sheet metal and gears. There's not much to it. A couple of pieces of wire in there. Figure out where they go. There's another stepper motor there I'm going to take out. And the rest goes in the trash. There's a roller there. Well, I hope that was fun stripping. But I mean, you can see I got a lot of wire out of it. After all that, that's all you get out of it. Most of it was just plastic and sheet metal, but I can use this. There's the extra wire that I need, so I'm happy. Later, guys.